meat, and many of the things that we will see today are history. Could one or many implementations for the same functionality? Mostly of the subsystems in our system have only one implementation because there was no need up to now to have more than one. There are a few that have several implementations, mainly the authentication system. For example, it's a system that its responsibility is to authenticate the users, and there are several implementations. Sometimes talk to an IP directory, someone talks to LDAP, others have hard-coded users and passwords for development. And putting one implementation instead of another, the system keeps working, just differs with communication does. An important aspect is that every subsystem that exists must have a clear defined interface and explicitly declare, or can implement more than one. This is, in Smalltalk, usually not needed because if it's polymorphic, it just works. But declaring it explicitly allows us to make some tests, make some conformance checks for more high level. Somebody that wants to do a new implementation has a reference of what have to do. And you can, well, we'll see that later. Okay. Also, it's possible that some subsystem requires the services for another subsystem in the system. So one important thing is to declare these dependencies. So in the startup of the system, when everything works together, this can be checked and see if the installation is consistent or not. Okay, these dependencies is not with a concrete implementation, sino with an interface. It's expressed about with an interface. We'll see some little code to see something like this. This is via Smalltalk, but this is similar to any other Smalltalk. Well, I will look at some particular implementation. This is not, it's more important, but the important thing is that you declare the interfaces you want to use, that you implement. And this is just, okay, if somebody says that is a system implementing the country management, had to provide implementation for these methods. Yes, this is like a Java interface, if you want, but there is no check that this must be conform. It's just informative and gives the user or the programmer a better understanding of what to do. The interface can be nested, could be parents, extend, and others, well, like any interface could do. And the dependencies, okay? In that case, this particular implementation relies on some system implementing the time system interface, so it's declared in that way. Okay. Up to now we talk about subsystems, but what is the whole system? It's the thing that makes all the work we want to do. It's just a composite system of the different subsystems that implement the functionality. Okay. Okay. Given a design installation, yes, a subset of all the available modules or some modules are another node. The only thing that one do is to register different subsystem implementations in the composite system. Yes, the main purpose of the composite system is just coordinate the startup and the shutdown of the another subsystems and provide a way to communicate between us. Okay, if this composition is dynamic, like a Smalltalk is dynamic, you on the fly can register a new subsystem if you provide all the requirements. this will work, or unregister some subsystem you want to unload some functionality. Okay, and the collaboration between the several subsystems is done by asking the composite, who knows all the subsystems installed, the current implementation for some interface. It's not attached to a particular implementation, it's done via messaging and through the whole system. Okay. Some clever things to do in that way. Yes? We're explicitly declaring the implemented interface and dependencies. So it's a good way to verify that it's a system declared to implement some interface. They have at least provided a method for everyone that the interface set that requires. Okay, this is easily done in Smalltalk. One can write some test that tests this particular subsystem, and it should be implementation independent. Yes, if I can country manage countries, and if the countries are in a collection or in a database or in another place and there is a connection, this must be hidden in implementation, but the interface remains the same. So the test, if I write a test that this says, okay, I start the system, I have no countries, and now we will add some country, and later I test that this country is present when I ask for countries again, this will work with every implementation. So, in most cases, this could be possible to write a test that could be run for every implementation. If you want to write a new implementation, provides a way to test if it's working correctly or not. Yes?
When you talk about dependencies,
yes.
Can you give me an example so that I can understand? Because the dependency is for the interface or...
The dependencies is for the implementation. Exactly. The interface has no dependencies.
Exactly.
A particular implementation could depend on another subsystem to work, and another implementation, maybe not.
Well, I thought you were referring to the interface of the, what dependency can an interface have.
Exactly. The dependency, it's done via the interface of the dependency, but just to not be tied to some particular implementation of the another system. Okay. There are other things you can test. For example, we have some conformance check. In particular, this is a decision that we take, but we don't have a private or public method, but we think, okay, if it's in the category that is not private, then don't contain private, we expect that if a system implements something public, there must be some interface. If not, probably I swap this implementation with another and it won't work. Okay? And of course, bueno, all of this is could be done automatically, tested, because the meta model allow us to reflect over to all of these things. The most difficult thing is to define the right interface. Usually, up to when there is only one implementation, everything seems fine. But when you have several implementations, it's complicated to determine the right interface. Okay, I will see some live systems running. In particular, these are a kind of production systems. Yes, I don't have the time to configure a particular system.
Could you mention an example of two different of a subsystem with two different?
Of course. Okay. We have a system who is for authentication, yes? His main interface is suppose authenticate the subject with that password. Mm-hmm. It's supposed a simple approach. Mm-hmm. One implementation, the one that we are using in development, has a list of users and password hard coded, and that's how the valid users and password. Mm-hmm. So I install the system. The rest of the system is the same, and I put this implementation, I can log in with Gabriel, white password, and everything works fine. In production, usually they have Active Directory, LDAP, some security system behind. So this implementation just connects with the system and do the authentication in that way. The only difference is what implementation is plugged in every way. This is the most common use. Later we will see some other uses that we found that are not maybe functional, but from the technical point of view, you can do some sharing, some login if you want. If I remember, sometimes one time there was a slow connection, so we implemented a kind of decorator, just cache some information and just put this implementation instead of the other.
I can help.
This is off on purpose.
No, what I want to say that when we started doing that system, we had some requirements, because the idea was that the system could work on different banks or financial institutions where they have already developed some data, like for example the customer system or the accounts or the customers and the security system. So the idea was to be able to plug different implementations of the same.
Say, or maybe it's more financial, but the quotes, the prices of the assets sometimes comes from Bloomberg, sometimes comes from Reuters, someone loads it, has the people that load this by hand, and just changing the implementation allow us with the same code base and the same system version, just configuring it, using it in different customers. Okay. I will try to pass this fast, but just we start to kind of customer installations, just to see that they have different systems installed. Okay, I will take a simpler one. The system runs in Shenzhen usually, but now we are running all in the image. It's the same. Okay, so we have a root system. Yes, this is the composite. And you can, the way that subsystem communicate basically is by system implementing. I don't know, suppose. Yes, some system that manage the instrument issuers. Yes, all the inter-subsystem communication is done by sending system implementing with the interface, and that way you get the current implementation that is active. Okay. In that case, this particular installation has 50 different subsystems installed. I will start another, and this will have another number of subsystems installed. Okay. Yes, in that case, this has 51. And maybe they are not the same implementations, but the idea is to just put the subsystem that I required for that customer in the required implementations. The others, just not put it, and that's all. Okay. Okay. Till now, this was the model maybe 4 years. I don't know when we started the X-Trail.
2004.
Okay. Yes, maybe 5 years, 4 years, this model has zero changes, I think. The last year we made some changes, mainly for a use case that we will see next. Okay, what's next? The last year we started to talk with companies that have a holding. I don't know if anybody says, knows what a holding is. Okay. Normally the people thinks that there is only corporation, but usually the big corporations have, I don't know, OSDE have OSDE Seguros, OSDE Medicina, OSDE Prepaga, yes, and different companies, different legal entities, but in fact they are the same owners and usually wants to see all the information consolidated, but the companies are different. Okay, it's important to not mix the information of every company, but some manager, a high-level manager, wants to see all the information consolidated, like if it was just one company. I think this is here, and in the world is even greater. Okay. So normally these holdings, all of these has much money to spend, and usually some of this money are in bonds and investments, so they want us to manage these investments. And these investments are made by different companies, so the cash flow, the money cash flow maybe enters for some company and goes out with another company. Okay? So some important things that we must consider. Every company employee in the holding should only have access using the system to this company information, unless there are grade level manager, but usually 90% of the employees are not. But some information must be shared. The customer don't want to type the same bond 5 times if they have 5 companies. Okay? Some employees are managers and want to see the holding information aggregated or some sub-part of the holding information aggregated. And we talk about again information, it's every information, all the information in the system. And the integration always wants that everything would be integrated. Okay, so we will see 3 changes that we are doing this year. Some of these were done previously, but later we see them as, oh, works for that case. Okay, I take this fast holding. Yes.
Yeah.
When fast have enough money and they don't know what to do with this, they vote for the casino and an insurance company.
It's a non-profit organization.
More t-shirts.
Always the holdings had to casino and insurance company. Okay, this is just to keep in mind. Okay, the customer wants that for every company, seems like if the system were distinct, because the usual way of doing this segregation of concerts is to implement complex security, I don't know, security profile that just this employee could see this information and touch everywhere in the system to do the thing, and it's complex and requires touching everything and error prone. So if from that side seems to be different companies, why just not start 2 systems? Seems to be a good idea. Okay, so if you have 2 companies in the holding, we can start even the same kind of installation, maybe the same implementations, but 2 times, and provide different entry points. So company information is never mixed from one company to another because it's separated. The security could be done, probably the authentication system maybe could be differently configured in every company. But the rest of the system, I think the installation must be the same. I don't need to change anything in the system. Okay, in that case we have taken insurance and casino. In that point there are just like two systems running in parallel. There are no connection between them. But this is not covered. All of this. There is the issue with information sharing. I don't want to put two people, different people to, I don't know. I have a stock and I don't want to type the stock in one system and then enter in the other and type the stock again. So the idea is to share this information. Like here, every single object, what we do is to provide the kind of decorator that is a shared subsystem. This is more implementation detail, in fact, because the systems usually have only one parent, embedded in only one composite system. Maybe if you start the design from zero, this kind of decorator for sharing is needed, but we need it. But the idea is that you take some implementation and okay, this is could be shared, and put it in different, register the same implementation, the same sharing implementation in all in the two systems. Okay. Later we will see it in live summary. Or maybe better now. Okay. I have a system running like this, something similar.
So the subsystem knows its parent system.
The subsystem, when it is registered in the composite system, later knows this parent system. This is a, now it's a design decision, but we by now we don't see problems with this. Okay, yeah, I will launch this ugly startup again. Right. Sorry. That way. Okay, but the startup starts a bit complex system like this that will we will see in the next slide. But for this, also works. Okay. In that demo, I have three globals with the systems. Usually there is something that manages the install systems, but for this purpose, I think it's okay. So we have an insurance system. Yes. They have some shareable system is the one we would want to share. In that case, it's the system that manages countries. And another system that is not shared. Okay, it's one of these systems. Sorry. This is very annoying. Okay. I will have a casino system. Yes. In that case, it's configured similar to the other, shares one of the implementations and not the other. Okay? We have the country manager system shared and the issuer system not shared in that case. So, if to the insurance system we ask the system implementing the country management system interface and ask it for countries, now we will, okay, it's empty. The same here. And we will register a country in one of these, okay? I will do it in the casino instance. Like it, this is shared, so I will see it in the two installations, okay? Here's the insurance. I have the country. Here's the casino, I have the country. Okay. We will continue. there is another thing that we don't see again. It's the aggregation, it's the manager levels. So what to do with the managers? They want to see a system like if it was a Unix system. But in fact, if you think it, normally managers don't do operating system. They just want to see information, aggregated information and nothing more. A manager doesn't do a transaction, doesn't buy stocks, and other people do this. So what we propose is to do, okay, start a new system representing the holding, and if you need some aggregation, I don't know, suppose you want to see all my investments aggregated, okay, just get that the aggregation implementation knows every other implementation in the other company systems that that have investments. So the manager, using the entry point of the holding, will see all the investments, like if it were in the same system. But every other employee just see the investments of the company in it works. Okay, this aggregation obviously is not. At least we found a generic way of doing it. Okay, this requires some coding, but it's pretty trivial. Okay, go back to Smalltalk. Okay, in that case, we have another system that manager issuers. And we have, this is not shared, okay? So here, we don't have issuers. Here, we don't have issuers. And in the holding, obviously, we don't have issuers. Okay? Keep in mind this figure. Well, I will register an issuer in the casino system. Okay. The insurance system doesn't see this, that change is not seen here. So there is no issuers. The casino obviously has the issuers. I don't know, in that case, Petrobras. And the holding, see the issue. Okay, but now nothing different. I will register now another issuer in the other system. So, the insurance system has IPF, the casino system has Petrobras, but from the point of view of the holding, if it's like this, all aggregated in the same place, okay, I will see everything. Okay. Okay. This covered all these points. Yes. Sorry. Yes, this point. The integration in that case is all small talk. In here is the same image. In deployment, usually the same sandstone stone. So everything runs, and just the entry points are different. Okay. Before the thanks, for the next year, I will have a crazy idea, but, well, I don't know if it could be implemented or not. But many, many users want to simulate things and say, I don't know, I have this investment, but what if I do some buy that stock? What happens to all the things that usually I measure in the system? What is my risk? What is my value of position? But I don't want to touch my investments, just to see what happens. Usually this is done by implementing a specific simulation for everything that the customer wants to see. But in fact, if you can create a system that is just like the other system, but the implementations keep separated the simulation, and aggregate it with the real information, most of the analysis tools will work. Okay? If I have some investments in the real system, and my simulated system can track the another investments that I do and aggregate that information, if I take these aggregated investments and give it to the system that, I don't know, give me the profit and losses, this will work. Doesn't matter if you're aggregated or not. It's transparent in that way. So, well, this is a crazy idea for the next year. If it is implemented, maybe we'll talk in some time. Okay. I will try to keep this short, so we will finish and see if there are questions. So much food. Okay, I will thank Hernán Wilkinson and Luciano Romeo, mainly the authors of the original subsystem design, that for many years works and keep working. So I think it was a good design, could be adapted easily. The whole Xtreme team for taking these ideas, doing the hard work. Obviously, I don't code all, and usually for discuss these kind of things, I don't know, we lose. From the outside, it seems that we lose many times having discussion, but it's useful. This is the way that these things emerge. All the Mercat software people, even if they don't have the opportunity to work in the X-Trail, and obviously everyone just for listening.
Are you using the subsystem concept also for packaging when you say your code, or is it just for part of the model?
It's part of the model. We don't have. There is no more way to package. I don't know. There are no packages in VA Smalltalk.
How do you save your code? You save the image?
In deployment, there is the gemstone image. Mm-hmm. So it's persistent, by the way. Mm-hmm. And the code is in the MB. Ah. The MB has something called configuration mask, but it's a bit tricky to do a package with this.
Okay. So
it's not
nothing
easy.
To do with
no, exactly. It's nothing to do. It's just a way of organizing the system.
Okay.
Well, can I say something about it? What he asked? When we decide how to package the application, we had so many problems with other applications that we forgot to package methods and everything, so we decided what the heck, we package everything. So we didn't care about that. So even in the...
We don't do a shrink usually. Yeah. All the code that is not test or but development just be in the packaging.
No, but that wasn't my question.
I think that you're talking about dependencies and all the things, no?
I don't know how VisualEdge solves the problem of saving your code.
Okay.
Because if you have parsers or something like that.
Yeah, it's the same thing.
There are something similar, but usually you don't have a strong dependence with implementations because the dependencies are with the interface. Mm-hmm. So there is pretty easy to keep it clean. I don't know. We don't have issues with recursive dependencies or things like that.
Okay. And my question was, when you have a shared
subsystem, if a
shared subsystem means a subsystem of the main system. Let's say the country system that is there means the time system.
Yes.
To get the time.
Yes.
And you have two different time systems.
No.
On the
we have a restriction that if you share some system, the dependence must be shared.
Okay.
For now, we don't have a case that this shouldn't be that way.
Okay, that makes sense.
So if you try to do this, the system will tell, okay, no, that's not valid.
Okay, cool.
How about the pairing, knowing the pairing? How do you manage that with a shared system?
Okay, like the dependencies are already shared because we post that. Doesn't matter what parent do you use. When you ask system implementing the dependency you need, there was shared, so it's the same.
You don't use the parent or...
We use one of the parents. In that case, it's the same because the dependencies are already shared.
So the parents are only used to get the dependency?
Yes, yes. That's the only purpose.
Okay, thank you. Okay.